welcome to Now That's What I Call a Pop Quiz. It's got all the big hits on one bumper album. What Happened Next by MC Theakston, The Picture Board remixed by Fatboy Suggs, and Mystery Guests featuring the notorious Noddy Holder. As ever, we've enticed some of the biggest pop stars in history to join us, offering them the chance to collaborate with two musical legends. But in the absence of Rene and Renato, will you please welcome Suggs? And Mr. Noddy Holder. Suggs' first guest has spent the last 10 years in the charts. After 11 top 10 hits with Eternal, she's now on course for a glittering solo career. Will you please welcome the very gorgeous Miss Kelly Bryan? Pop princess Kelly is joined by a rock queen. Well, kind of. A staggering 24 top 10 hits, including the nation's song of the millennium, Bohemian Rhapsody. They've won every music award worth winning. From Queen, will you please welcome the legendary Roger Taylor? That completes the residents in Suggs' House of Fun and in Noddy's Corner. They're all crazy now, and the first guest fights like me da. They've had four consecutive singles go straight in at number one, sold over 3 million albums, and single-handedly kept the Irish denim industry afloat. From Bewitched, it's Lindsay. Yeah. Our final guest is, according to Bono, the Noel Coward of her generation. Daughter of legendary folk singer Ewan MacColl, she's collaborated with the likes of The Pogues, Talking Heads and The Smiths. Critics are hailing her new album as the best of her career. It is, of course, Kirsty MacColl. Let's get straight on with the first round. OK, 2 points for correctly identifying the pop star behind each number. As always, you can confer, but give me the wrong answer and I will offer it over. OK, first up, Kelly, pick a number.
Two.
Number two. Who is this?
It's,
What's her name?
Yeah,
Tommy Lee Jones.
Yeah.
Go on, Kelly.
Tommy Lee Jones.
From Motley Crue? Is the right answer. 2 points. Lindsay, pick a number.
Number seven.
You think so?
Definitely one of them.
Somebody who can't read, obviously.
You're close.
I think it's Liam.
Liam Gallagher.
Is wrong. I'm going to hand it over for 2 points, Suggs. Do you know who it is?
Ooh. It's got to be his brother, hasn't it? Yeah. Is it Noel Gallagher?
In the papers again, Mr. Noel Gallagher, 2 points.
Thank you.
Coffee already?
Noddy, it's not St. Patrick's Day today, is it, mate?
Because I'm Irish.
Irish, the leprechaun look. Fitted in on my guest. Being
respectful. Yeah. Roger, pick a number.
One.
Number one.
I think she's right. Robbie.
Yeah, is, could it be Robbie Williams?
It could. 2 points. Well done, Roger. Kirsty, your turn. Pick a number, please.
10.
Number 10.
Oh, no.
We get the hard ones.
We get them, ain't we?
Oh. You'll have to go for it. We'll have to go for a guess, won't we?
Yeah, this is just a guess, really. Shania Twain.
It's a good guess. It's not right, sadly.
Oh, no.
For 2 points, Suggs.
It's not Jerry Elliott.
No.
So should we say Victoria, then?
Quite tiny.
I don't think it's right.
No, it's not right, though, is it?
No.
Posh Spice.
Victoria Beckham is wrong. It is, in fact, Cyndi Lauper.
Ah, well.
Suggs, your call. Pick a number.
Number four, please.
Number four.
Looks a bit like my next-door neighbour. But he's not in a band. No. A few tattoos. Tommy Lee Jones' brother. And the big middle part in there, no.
You don't know, do you?
No, we don't know.
No, I didn't think so. We'll hand it over. Noddy, any idea? He might be training seals in that pool, possibly.
Training seals manager.
Down then, doesn't he?
I haven't a clue.
He
Oh, I know you mean. I know you mean.
No, not gonna kill.
Can we come back to it?
It's a killer. No.
Can we come back to it?
Can we come back to it?
You can't. Do you know who it is? Oh. I'm not giving you any points.
Adamski.
It is Adamski. Oh, yeah. But no points there, sadly. Oh. Okay, finally, Noddy, you're 6-0 down.
Thanks. Done it again. I'll have number 12.
Number 12.
It's got to be Madonna, isn't it?
Yeah, it's got to be, but it's not.
Is it Kylie Minogue?
It is. Kylie Minogue.
Oh, God, baby. You're
worth 2 points.
We should try to get a bit foxy, isn't it?
Okay, after our first visit to the picture board, the scores are Noddy has a very creditable naught, whereas Suggs is in the lead with 8 points. We'll start the pop action with Name the Year. Kelly, watch these clips and see if you can tell me the year and who claims they never wrote music.
Men were men and women were women, you know.
Longevity as a human being. I want it to last forever.
I never actually wrote any songs, just used to mess around on the piano and things. All I know is that's me. You look like you're at a fan. Open up your loving arms. Watch out,
Chris.
Chris. Chris.
Chris.
No. Is it? No. Yeah, Chris.
Could be, could be. Yeah, okay.
Okay, so...
So what's the year, Kelly?
I think the year's 84, going for the Madonna kind of vibe, David Bowie vibe, and we think it's Chris...
Roger?
Chris Lowe?
Chris Lowe?
I'll give you a point for Chris Lowe from the Pet Shop Boys, but the year is wrong. It wasn't 1984, Noddy.
Got the other one then.
We decided between 83 or 85.
Yes.
My two companions say 85.
And they'd be right, so you get a point for that. Noddy's off the mark.
But what were you going to say, Noddy? What were you going to say?
First point's always a tough one. Your turn, Lindsay, though. Once again, we need the year. And this time, who's talking about Sham 69?
All right, love, that's enough. Thank you very much.
What a gay day. Shut the door. About the new band's craze.
Sham 69 as a band of a time. They're doing it like a day. Allow us, we'll show you the way. Oh, freak out. You
freak, it's a sheep. Freak out. One of the earliest, yeah. Point for each.
Gonna go for Sting. Sting is the artist. Talking about Sham 69, and the year was 78.
Sure.
No.
It's worth 2 points, though. Well done. Now then, pop music is no longer just a preserve of old rockers wearing leather and never knowing when to pack away their drum kits. Roger, the likes of Billy and S Club 7 have proved that age isn't a barrier in the pop stakes.
Who?
So have a look at these chart-topping kids and tell me which two had hits with I Want You Back.
Hello, everybody. My name's June. What's you?
Two right. Artists we're after, it's worth a point each.
Jackson 5 is one.
Who did the other one then? Don't tell me it was...
I want you back.
I didn't... I was Cleopatra in the... I didn't see whether they were in
there
or not.
Yeah, hold on. It was Cleopatra and the Jackson 5.
Jackson 5 had a number 2 hit in 1970, as did Cleopatra in 1998. Well done, 2 points.
I said number 2 in the quiz time.
Now, Kirsty, not wanting to incur the wrath of anyone who remembers vinyl, let's pay tribute to a few of our best-known pop veterans. Have a close look at these and tell me which two have had number one hits in the last 3 years.
The riff goes like this.
I still believe in doing what I'm doing.
Well, tonight I'm gonna live for today, so come along for the ride. I hope I'm on before I die.
So, Kirsty, two of those old masters have had number ones in the last 3 years. Do you know who they were?
We're going for Cher and Cliff.
Cher with I Believe in 1998 and Cliff's Millennium Prayer the year after. 2 points, well done. So, that means the scores stand at Noddy on 5, but still in the lead, Suggs with 11. Round 3, all you have to do is guess what happened next. An example might be that we see the beginning of Gary Barlow's solo career and you have to tell me what happened next. Tough one. But Suggs, I'd like your team to watch this first appearance on television by an unknown collection of Irish lads back in 1993. And you have to tell us what happened next.
Sorry, you don't play any instruments or have any songs.
No.
You do.
They don't.
They don't.
They're lying. They don't. We're not going to be playing them on a stage and all backing tracks, live vocal.
So, the lads don't have any songs to sing. So what do they do to entertain that young, lively audience?
I think Kelly thinks she knows. They look good, though. They look well, didn't they?
Look fantastic.
Kelly, what do you think happened next?
I think what happens next is two of the boys, I think it's Ro and Shane, start dancing, like, giving it some.
Really?
Yeah.
OK, well, let's what take a look.
Yeah, see? Giving it some. That's giving it some.
Not strictly dancing, but I'll give it to you. 2 points. Well done, Kelly. To 1984 and Galaxy with the remarkably agile Phil Fearon. Noddy, Lindsay and Kirsty, take a look at this quality bit of disco and see if you can guess what happens next. Class clip. Noddy, any ideas?
We're getting some stinkers tonight. That's any idea?
Can we have another one? It's not obscure enough.
Surely everyone remembers Phil Fearon.
Oh, I remember the band. Does the track stop and everything falls apart?
Like you think the backing track finishes?
Yeah,
and they all stop. They're still
giving it some.
Still dancing.
No, it's not that.
Suggs, any idea?
We saw a young girl go past the front of the shot there. Who may or may not have exposed herself, we think she did. She lifted her top up like that.
Well, no.
OK.
Let's take a look at what actually happened. Everybody's laughing there with Phil Fearon. It was actually the name of the song, but there we go. Well, after those instantly forgettable pop moments, the scores are... Noddy on 5, Suggs with a seemingly unassailable lead of 13. Now a chance for everyone to bag some easy points by picking an A-side question for 1 point or try a harder B-side for 2 points. Kelly, what'll it be?
A, please.
A-side. OK, which artist featured in both Purple Rain and Under the Cherry Moon?
Prince.
Is the right answer. Yes. 1 point. OK, Lindsay, A-side or B-side? bearing in mind that you are 9 points behind.
Do you want to try a B?
B.
Okay, who was the first British female to top the UK charts with a self-composed song?
A self-composed song?
Lindsay, how old were you in 1978?
78? Well, I know.
I was
Kate
one.
Bush.
You were one?
Kate Bush.
Yeah, you see, you're going to struggle with this.
Kate Bush.
With Wuthering Heights is the right answer. Yeah. 2 points. Tough one. Wow. Okay, Roger, A side or B side?
Oh dear, they're catching up. I'll take a try a B.
You're going to go.
I wouldn't say they were catching up, but. B side?
Yeah.
We're going to rub their noses in it. We're going to rub their noses.
B side. Who were the last duo to have a number one Christmas hit with an original recording?
I think someone's recording.
Did they have a number one?
Yeah, couldn't know, but they're a group.
There's only two of them, though, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it could be. Yeah. Wham. Yeah.
It's not Wham, no.
Do you want to try? Try yours.
Yeah, but it wouldn't have been original, would it? Is there anything we can think of? Robson and Jerome.
It's the wrong answer, covers, I'm afraid. Yeah. They were cover versions. It was, in fact, Rene and Renata. Oh. Darling, Save Your Love.
I was going to go.
Back in 1982.
And how we all love that.
how we miss it. Kirsty, A side or B side?
Oh, we need the points, don't we? B-side, yeah.
B-side. Which two artists wrote We Are the World in 1985?
Midger and Bob Geldof. The other one. That's the other one. That was the British version.
OK.
Not right.
No, I could have sworn I heard them say an answer.
I'm saying Michael Jackson and Stevie Wonder.
It's wrong.
Lionel Richie and Michael Jackson.
Is right. Well done, Roger. 2 points. Yes. Okay, now, Suggs, you don't get the choice. You'll be having a B-side, so listen to this, and after it, I will ask you a question worth 2 points. Here you go. That was, of course, Tight Fit's number one hit from 1982, but which other band have recorded it as a B-side? Was it EMF, ABC or REM?
The thought of any of them, really.
It wasn't REM for a start.
No? You've got all their B-sides, have you, Kelly?
No, it definitely wasn't them. Can you give us the other two again, please?
REM, EMF or ABC?
I think EMF, because they were sort of daft, weren't they?
Yeah.
In the nicest possible, you know. EMF, Jamie.
Is the wrong answer.
Ouch.
For 2 points, Noddy.
It's so off the wall, we've got to say REM.
Is the right answer.
No.
Originally by the Tokens in 1961, Carl Denver had a hit with it back in 1962. OK, Noddy, have a listen to this.
Indeed.
It's another number one from the Pet Shop Boys in 1985, but which other band had a top 20 hit with it? Was it Go West, E17 or North and South?
It was E17.
Is the right answer for 2 points. Okay,
then he says, I'm dead modern.
Yeah. A frightening contact. At the end of that round, Noddy has 11 points, but still in the lead. It's Suggs with 16.
We're coming for it. We're going.
Yeah. 2 points on offer here. If you can spot our mystery guests, Suggs, Kelly, and Roger, who's the lead dancer with the Praise You dance troupe?
I have to praise you like I should.
Thank you. one last year, but any ideas who was leading that merry dance? Suggs, it's not easy.
Mr. Fearless.
It was that Bernard Levin.
Got Bernard Levin or Jackie Palo so far. But neither of them.
Should we move along already, or are you happy to pursue one of those?
Didn't they make records? Mick Hucknall.
Mick all Hucknall right. With the red hair.
We give up.
It's not. It's not the right answer.
We do give up.
Will you give up?
Weren't you, Jamie? Was it?
Funnily enough, no.
I know his face. Just can't put a name to it.
Is it Keith Allen?
No.
Yeah. Don't know. We don't know.
Well, let's take a look who it actually was.
Oh, no.
Well.
The one and only Mr. Leo Sayer. Okay, Noddy, Lindsay, and Kirsty, you've got a touch of classic ABBA now. See if you can identify these Swedish beauties.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go, if you're feeling down. If you're all alone, when the pretty birds are flying, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. Gonna do my very best, and it ain't no lie. If you put me to the test, if you let me try.
So, Lindsay, any ideas?
Yes, Daphne and Celeste.
Daphne and Celeste. Let's see if you're right.
Ooh, thank you, your mama too, and your daddy. Ooh, thank you, your mama too.
Well done.
Yes. It was, of course, rock legends Daphne and Celeste. Now, with only a couple of rounds to go, the scores are Noddy catching up with 13, but Suggs just holding off with 16. The picture board now, same rules apply. 2 points for a right answer, 6 pictures left. Kelly, pick a number.
8, please.
Number 8.
Why are they all saints? No.
It's not Nicole.
No, it's not Chesney, is it?
No.
Hey?
Okay, then we'll guess it's an All Saint, but I don't know which one.
An All Saint isn't good enough, sadly.
Yeah, go on, just one of them, quick. Yeah, we're on it. Come on, which one is it? The other one.
Natalie
is the wrong answer.
Oh, there.
Yeah. Go on then.
MacColl from All Saints
is the right answer.
MacColl what?
Did you say it's definitely not MacColl?
No.
Yes, you did.
Sorry.
Getting tight. There's 1 point in it. Lindsay, pick a number, please.
9.
If you get this right, you'll go into the lead.
Mick Hucknall.
The publicity shy Mick Hucknall it is. 2 points.
I can't believe it.
Roger, I don't want to put any pressure on, but it's getting tight.
Yeah.
Pick a number.
6, please.
Number 6.
Oh. I think it could be me.
Sorry?
That could be myself, I'm afraid. I'm the one on the left.
Mr. Roger Taylor, yeah, it is. I'm Roger Taylor, well done. What on earth are you doing there? Will you explain to us why you're dressed up in drag?
I do it all the time. It was Elton John's 50th, I think.
Ah,
oh,
yeah. Wonderful. OK, Kirsty, pick a number.
11.
Number 11. Status quo. Mm.
Oh, of course it is.
Is
yeah.
It?
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Another bunch of bruises.
Oh, Noddy knows this.
Status
sure?
quo.
All right, status quo.
Status quo. For 2 points is the right answer.
Yeah.
Suggs, a point behind. Two.
Thanks, left. Jamie.
Which is it to be, 3 or 5?
3, please.
Number 3.
Could it be Mel B?
Do you think?
Maybe.
It could be Mel B. In fact, we think it is.
Mel B, Mel G, Scary Spice, it's all the same. It's worth 2 points.
Well, yes! Thank you.
Five, of course.
Number five for Noddy.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Oh, come on.
We'll go for Britney Spears.
Britney Spears?
Yeah.
Final answer? Britney Spears is right. The Riverdance years is worth 2 points. So, with only one round to go, Suggs has 20 points, but for the first time in the lead, Mr. Noddy Holder with 21. OK, now we sort the pop stars from the five stars. 2 points for a right answer, give me a wrong answer, and it won't be offered to the opposition, but your team will be deducted a point. No pressure, but it all hangs on this final round. So, here we go. Question number one. What does the R in R. Kelly stand for? Kelly.
Robert.
Is the right answer. Whose highest UK hit was Like a Rolling Stone? Roger.
Bob Dylan.
Is correct. Lisa Left Eye Lopez is a member of which band? Kelly.
TLC.
Correct. Name the world's biggest ever selling single. No conferring, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Candle in the Wind. I think your Suggs knew it, but you didn't, so you're going to lose a point, we unfortunately. Did. Who performed We Will Rock You with five at this year's Brit Awards? Oh. Lindsay.
I can't remember his name now.
Queen!
Oh, yeah!
I'm sorry, you're going to have to lose a point. It's on your own, unfortunately, so we're going to deduct a point. It was, of course, Roger Taylor and Brian May. Who had top 10 hits with Naked and Arms Around the World? Kelly.
My buddy Lou.
She and nearly pushed the point. Desk over there.
Who produced Iggy Pop's Lust for Life? Roger.
David Bowie.
Is the correct answer. Kelly Jones is the lead singer with which Welsh band?
Very funny.
We'll let you have it, because it doesn't make any difference. Well done, it was a Stereophonics. Exciting stuff. The scores are Noddy with 22, but this week's winners with 29, Suggs' team. To Kirsty and Lindsay, our gallant losers, and thanks to Roger and Kelly, our honourable champions. We'll see you next Saturday for even more Questions of Pop. Until then, thanks for watching. Good night.
And next Saturday, a Question of Pop is at the slightly later time of 20 past six. Well, two fans of Boyzone are about to get the biggest shock of their lives. Gabby Roslin has Whatever You Want next here on BBC One Scotland.